maths. In today's lecture, we are going to solve question number 3, 4 and 5 in the practice 5.1. As you know, yesterday we have started our new chapter fraction, and yesterday's lecture I have introduced you with the fraction. What is in the fraction? As you know, fraction is part of whole. Okay, so see here, yesterday first two questions you have solved, in which you have written the fraction for the shaded parts, and in the second question you have written a fraction for the unshaded parts. Okay, in this practice 5.1, next question is question number 3, write the fraction for each of the following, and question number 4 is write the fractional number for each of the following. Now fraction means what and fractional number means what? Yesterday I have told you fraction means what and fractional number means what. Yes, I have told you yesterday fraction means what, when we write in this way, in the numerical form, 4 upon 7, what? When we write fraction in this form, it is called fraction. And it's when we write this in the spelling word, that is called fractional number. Okay, so see here, write a fraction for each of the following. 4/5, this is the fractional number. This fractional number, this as it is given in the spelling. Okay, 4/5 we have write in the fraction. So 4/5 means 4 upon 5. 4 upon 5. 4/5 means 4 upon 5. Similarly, 2/6 means 2 upon 6. This is the fraction for 2/6. 3/7. If you see here, when the fractional numbers are given, there are two parts, 3 and 7. The first number is as usual, counting number 3, 4, 5, likewise. And second part, the number which is given, it is ordinary number. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, likewise. Okay? TH is there. These are ordinary number. Okay? So, ordinary number comes in the denominator, and simple number, counting number, comes in the numerator. That's it. So 3/7 means 3 upon 7. Okay, understood? Then question number 4. Write the fractional number. Now you see fraction are given. Fractions are given, and you write them into the spelling, that is in fractional number. Now 5 upon 7. How to write 5 upon 7 or 5/7? So we have to write it this way. 5. The number which is above the bar, write as it is 5, and number which is below the bar, write in the form of ordinal number. Okay, 7. Seven. 8 upon 9, that is the number which above the bar, write as it is 8, and 9, don't write 9, like you have to write 9th. Okay, 9. N-I-N-T-H, 9. 7 upon 10, you write it this way, 7, 10. Okay, the number which is below the bar, you have to write it in the form of ordinal number. Okay, ordinal number, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, in this way. Understood? Now see question number 5. This is very important question, and this is what we can say, application based question. How many 1/10 are there in a whole? How many 1/10 are there in a whole? Now you know 1/10 means what? 1/10 means 1 upon 10, right? 1/10 means 1 upon 10. Such, how many fraction or parts of fraction will you get in the whole? Suppose there is one whole. This is, we can say, chocolate, and it is divided into 10 equal parts. It is divided into 10 equal parts. One, two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. As we, 1 10th, there are, so the number below the bar means what indicates total equal parts, right? So this is one street we can say, and divide into 10 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, if you share one part, if you share one part, then what fraction you can write for this? 1 out of 10 or 1 upon 10, right? 1 by 10. Such, this is this one part in this tree, in this whole tree, complete tree, one part is 1 upon 10. Understood? One part is 1 upon 10. Why 1 upon 10? Because the whole street or whole chocolate, if you consider whole chocolate, is divided into 10 equal parts. So, and out of 10 equal parts, 1 is shaded, that means it indicates 1 upon 10. 1 upon 10, as we know that the number below the bar represents total equal parts and number above the bar represents shaded part. Okay, so this shaded part, if one part, if you have taken, then it represents 1 upon 10, that is 1 10. Such, how many 1 10s are there in this whole complete chocolate? How many 1 10s are there? See. This one part is 1 10. This one part is 1 10. This one part is 1 10. Similarly for all, 1 upon 10. Each part in this tree represent 1 10. Okay, so how many 1 10s are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 1 10. So there are 10 1 tens in a whole. Understood? So there are 10 1 tens in a whole. Meaning is clear. 10, 1 tenth they have asked. So 10th represent the total equal parts in that chocolate. And out of 10, there is one is there in the above the bar, that means 1 is shaded. So this one part indicates 1 10, that means similarly all the remaining, each part indicates 1 10, 1 10, 1 10. Such 10 1 10 are there in this whole chocolate. Okay, second question is also same like this. How many 1 7th are there in a whole? So here also same, 1 7th means means 1 upon 7, right? Means suppose if you can take, you have taken that chocolate. Now this time the chocolate is divided into how many equal parts? 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And out of 7, 1. 1 is above the bar, that means 1 is shaded, suppose. So this one part represent 1 7th, okay? Such how many 1 7ths are there in this whole chocolate? So this is 1, then this one part represent 1 7th, this one part individually represent 1 7th, likewise each part represent 1 7th. So how many 1 7ths are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are 7 1 7th in a whole. Got it? Okay, so in suppose the question is asking this, how many 1 8th are there in a whole, then there will be 8 1 8 will be there in a whole. Okay, because whatever total number of parts are there, that much 1 8th will be there in that whole chocolate or whole object. Understood? So hope you understood this. Tomorrow's lecture we will see the next concept in the chapter, that is numerators and denominators. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.